Good evening, everyone. So today we are starting lecture number 2.3. Instead of interacting on a synchronous mode, I thought this particular lecture can be given in asynchronous mode. So in this particular lecture, let us see what we are going to look at. If we look at the module 2 on grinding mechanism and mechanics, all of them, all the sub parameters or sub modules or topics under this module, they have been covered. Okay. Now, what has not been covered is this particular thing, grinding chips and what and their analysis. What kind of grinding chips are produced, and can we infer something by looking at them? So we will talk about this today in this particular lecture. So already we know what are the chip formation, what are the material removal mechanism in grinding, that we have already dealt with in detail. I will simply go through the basics of them once again so that you can recollect very easily. So there is one micro cutting action. So by this micro cutting action, chips are produced. So this micro cutting action is very much like micro milling action of the abrasive grids. There is primary rubbing, this has been discussed. There is plowing. What has not been discussed is this particular guy, which we are calling as secondary rubbing. Another thing that we have not discussed is microfracturing. What is secondary rubbing? We will discuss it in this particular slide. And what is microfracturing? For brittle work materials, like carbides, ceramics, for them microfracturing is the predominant mode of material removal. However, for metallic alloys which are harder and brittle like HSS, along with micro cutting, this micro fracturing would also be present. So these processes, micro cutting, primary rubbing, plowing, micro fracturing, do they produce a particular kind of chip? That's what we would like to see. And if you recall, because of the rotation of the grinding wheel, the grit is supposed to move from A to C, as because you also give a feed VW, that is the work speed, it is supposed to move from A to B, but because of this primary rubbing, it cannot penetrate instantly, so it moves to A to D, then D to D prime it penetrates, and from D prime to B it generates chips by micro cutting action. From A to D, from this A to D, there is primary rubbing. What is plowing also we have explained. In this particular diagram, this is your direction of VS, but in this diagram VS is directed towards you, so it is in the plane which is perpendicular to this particular above picture. In this, the grit is coming towards you. Instead of the material ahead of the grit getting removed by micro cutting action, plowing is taking place. They are getting displaced in the sideways direction, and this is called plowing. This is very similar to the term which is used in agriculture, which is displacement of the mother earth or soil alongside the furrow instead of getting removed. So this also happens, and this is the VW or work speed vector that has been shown here. This has been discussed. What are the material removal mechanisms or what are the energy consumers? This has been discussed. Now, what is secondary rubbing? Because I explained to you or I told you that this will take place. Secondary rubbing takes place from D prime to B. So, this if this is your grit, at the grit tip, when chip formation is working, is taking place simultaneously at the grit tip, secondary rubbing would also take place. So, chip formation will occur here and simultaneously here secondary rubbing will take place. So, this happens from D prime to B in this particular zone. So, that is also something like primary rubbing, but this is associated with energy consumption, but as because micro cutting takes place, chip formation also takes place. Now, let us see an interesting video. In this video, in this particular video, what we are going to see is chip formation, the actual chip formation. How we are going to see? By simulation as well as by experimentation. This video has not been created by me. This video has been coming from University of Technology Kozalin. That is the way they write university in their language. This is a Polish university. From that it is coming in. I have taken their video and edited it for using in the class. So, courtesy goes to them. So, first thing that we are going to see is the numerical simulation. So, for numerical simulation, so that is the first thing we are going to see. So, this is the grid. So, this is the grid, and as you can see, chip formation is taking place. So, this is the chip formation, and this is the furrow, which is the groove, grinding groove, which is simultaneously occurring. This is another view. Here also the chip formation can be seen, but in this you must be able to see something which is very interesting. See these small chips which are forming along with a long chip. These small irregular chips are also forming. So, from this itself you can say that what kind of chips, or you can guess what kind of chips would be forming. So, there are long chips, something like a milling chip or something, and there are smaller chips which are also forming. They have also carried out experiments. So, this is the grit which is moving. Initially there is no chip formation. So, primary rubbing, and then a chip is forming which is like a long chip. And along with that, you can see small chips are forming and flowing away. So, this is the experimental part they have done. They must have done it in a scratch tester or a reciprocating system. This is once again the numerical simulation that I am bringing in so that you get to see what is happening. So, that's it. This is the numerical simulation. From this numerical simulation, let us see what are the different types of chips, how do they look like. And let us associate different interaction mechanism with the form of the chip that is created. So, there are different kinds of forms of chips. What are they? There are shear type chips. These type of chips are produced by micro cutting action of the abrasive grits, and if you recall, the average rake is negative and it is along around -60°. In this shear type chips, you have long chips, you have short chips, you have leafy chips. All of them will be shown to you. There are irregular chips which do not have any form. And there are spherical chips and there are broken chips. Each one of them, they are associated with a particular type of interaction. Now, this is a ACM microphotograph. This is a ACM microphotograph. Here you can see some chips. Here also you have certain kind of chips. They are not very visible. So let us go to the next figure and see next. One, and let us have a look at it. Now the previous one, these chips, they were obtained while grinding an alloy which is called Inconel 718. So Inconel 718 is a nickel based super alloy. These are used in aerospace industry. Where exactly they are used, you try to find out whenever you get time. This is obtained while grinding steel. This has been obtained while grinding steel with alumina inside, alumina grits, alumina abrasive wheel. And as you can see, there are certain grits, certain chips. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 1, 5. There are a lot of chips which look exactly spherical. What is the mechanism of formation of these chips? I will explain them. This particular type of chip, let us put them as star. They almost look like shear type chips and they are long. There are short shear type chips. This is a short shear type chip. This is a short shear type chip. And we also talked about a type of chip which is irregular chip. So these are irregular chips. This one is irregular. They do not have a particular shape. This is a irregular chip. This is a irregular chip. So how these chips are produced, that we are going to explain. So micro cutting by abrasive grits, they produce shear type chips. And these shear type chips can be long, it can be leafy, and it can be short. So you have seen long and short chips. This is a long shear type chip, whereas this is a short shear type chips. And they also produce irregular chips. Irregular chips forms primarily because of chip breaking that you have seen in the video. What we have not explained in this, we have not explained how these spherical chips forms, that we have not explained. We have not shown you what is a leafy chip and what is a broken chips. Irregular chips also we have shown you. So let us go to the next one and see whether we can see other chips or not. In this we also cannot see this. This particular photograph has been taken from the book of Malkin. So if you have the electronic copy of Malkin, you would be able to see. So this is a nice spherical chip. What is the size of this? This is 20 micron. So roughly the diameter of this spherical chip is around 40 micron. Other than that, they are all long shear type chip. In this particular photograph, nothing else has been visible. You might say, how we are taking these photographs at such a high magnification? We are taking this with a scanning electron microscope. In our department we have one such, though it has been taken from Malkin, but this particular photograph was taken in our department. So we roughly call it, or we in short we call it SEM, scanning electron microscope. So this photograph has been taken in scanning electron microscope. What is this? This is once again a irregular chip. This one is a irregular chip. This one is a irregular chip. Whereas this is a long shear type chip. So if you have long shear type chip profusely available in your collected chips, then you can say the micro cutting is taking place, and micro cutting is very, very predominant. If you have lot of irregular chips during cutting, you can say along with micro cutting, chip breaking is taking place. When chip breaking would take place? When the work material is brittle. So if you are grinding a brittle work material, so along with long shear type chip, irregular materials, would irregular things would also be happening. This brittle means this is a metallic alloy. This is not a carbide or a ceramic. For a carbide or a ceramic, something other kind of chip would be available. Along with shear chip, there would be profuse amount of micro fracture chips that we will come to. Now, what is this? This is at a very high magnification. This much is 1 micron. So, from this distance to this distance is 1 micron. What can you see? You can see lot of segments or serrations. So, these are basically long sheared type chips, and each one of them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and these are the lamella which are forming due to the primary shearing process. So if you can recall or if you can study, this corresponds very well with the Pispanen model of chip formation that you must have studied in machine tool or machining, or now you are studying in theory of machining, wherever it is. So these are the clear shear lamellas which are visible. Now this is interesting. This particular photograph shows you a grinding chip or a spherical grinding chip. What else do you see? It is hollow, it is not solid. This is the hole through which the inner surface can be seen, and it is completely hollow. So when people have observed that there are spherical chips obtained in grinding, people thought there is melting and resolidification which are producing these spherical chips. This theory is wrong. Melting and resolidification theory is wrong. What happens? If you have a chip like this, which is forming, this is the outer surface of the chip, and this side is the rear surface of the chip, which is rubbing against the abrasive, and the temperature goes up. As the temperature goes up, this chip curls and it oxidizes. Particularly if it is made of steel, it oxidizes. As it oxidizes, the temperature further increases and it takes the form of a sphere or a curled up sphere. So this is the basic theory of formation of spherical chip. So if you have large number of spherical chips present in your collected chips, it indicates temperature was high, because if initial temperature was not high, this curling would not take place, initial oxidation would not start. Once oxidation starts, temperature would be high, but for oxidation to take place, initial temperature has to be high. So if you have profuse number of spherical chips, that indicates your initial grinding temperature was high. Now let us come to leafy chips. Leafy chips means, what is a leaf? This is a leaf. I do not know from which plant it is. There is a single stem, and after that there are branches. In leafy chips you do not have branches, but you do have a single stem. As you can see, this is the stem, and on both sides you have this leaf like structure. There are lamellas, as you can see. Those lamellas look like those branch veins or something. This is the central vein. Here also you can see, this is the central vein, and on both sides you have that. How they are formed? They are formed by microcutting action. Only thing is that while you are microcutting, the orientation of the grit is such like that the VS is something like this. So this is one of the central ridge, central line or cutting edge against which both the cutting edges, this one and what you cannot see is on this side, both of them they participate, and there is a central parting point which produces this particular ridge. So leafy chip would be available if you have shear type chips. Some of them would be leafy, some of them would not be leafy. In this diagram, as you can see, this is a spherical chip, this is a small irregular chip, this is also a small irregular chip. Some of them, they do not have scale markers. So, most of them, they should have scale marker. This is a new kind of chip that we have seen. This is, we have given a name, it is like a tadpole chip. Okay, so this is like a tadpole chip, that means it has a head, which is basically a spherical chip, and a tail. Basically, this is a completely, the full spherical chip has not formed. This was a long shear type chip which underwent or which was undergoing oxidation. At that point of time, it has been captured. This tail part could not curl around and give you a full sphere. Now, let us come to the next one. Oh God. So, these are the different types of chips, and we have shown you what is a shear type chips, their variants, long, short, leafy. During formation of the shear type chips, because of chip breaking, irregular chips form, you have spherical chips. Spherical chips, once again, they form because of curling of long sheared chips, and their subsequent oxidation. This is primarily found for steel, and they are hollow. They do not form through melting and resolidification. So this is wrong. This hypothesis was proposed long back, but this hypothesis is incorrect hypothesis. Now, what we have not shown you, they are broken chips. As you can see, this is a small broken chip. The size is very, very small. This is around 2 micron. So, this is around 6 to 7 micron. They are profusely broken chips everywhere. You would not be able to find any kind of chip. What is this? This is a sintered alumina ceramic. So, compared to metallic alloys, its fracture toughness is much less and it is very, very brittle. This has been ground, plant surface ground, by diamond grinding wheel. This has been captured here. This experiment has been done in our lab. So, by diamond grinding wheel, and you primarily obtain this kind of broken chips. Why do you get broken chips? Because while you are grinding ceramic materials, it is much more energy efficient if chip breaking takes place rather than micro cutting. Instead of alumina, if you would have ground something which is called yttria stabilized zirconia, whose toughness is a bit higher. For this kind of material, along with broken chips, you might have got some short shear type chips as well, which I do not have an example today, but this has been observed quite often. So, to summarize, by looking at collected chips, during grinding, if you collect your chips, so in the spark stream by a robotic mechanism or with sufficient amount of health and safety measures, if you collect it with your hand on a glass slide, clean them, dry them, and observe them under ACM, by looking at the chips, you can conclude what kind of grit workpiece interaction is taking place. If you have profuse number of spherical chips while grinding steel, you can find out that material temperature is high. If you have more number of irregular and broken chips even during grinding a steel, then you can say that somehow it is behaving like a brittle material. If you have profuse number of long leafy shear type chips, then you can say you are basically grinding a material where micro cutting is predominant. If you have broken chips, the most probably the material is having lower fracture toughness, or under the grinding condition it is behaving like a brittle material. Thank you so much. This particular video is being recorded for tomorrow's class from 9 to 10. Thank you so much. Good night.